Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to my channel. If you're coming here for the first time, I'm a mentor for RBI, SEBI, NABARD and UGC NET examinations. Yesterday, I received two calls from my students. And surprisingly, both the students had the same problem. Addiction to mobile phones. Students are considered to be the most vulnerable lot and the most addicted towards mobile phones. So I thought, what are the ways in which we can get rid of this addiction? These students who called me were asking for a solution, and although I gave them a solution based on my personal experience, it was not very structured and very organized so that they could follow it by heart. So I thought, let me grab a notebook, write down the things that I have been doing in order to get rid of this addiction myself as well, so that I can share it with you guys and you can actually use it or implement these strategies in your life. I am very sure because of the lockdown and the undergoing COVID situation, majority of you would be addicted to mobile phones by now. So let me tell you these 5 points that I am going to discuss today. The first point is priority. You have to tell yourself what is your most important priority in your life at this point of time. Mobile phones have the power to influence us and to tell us that every call or every message that we are receiving might be an emergency or might be an urgent call or a message, and therefore we need to get to it. In reality, that is not the case. More than 99% of the calls are actually not urgent and they could be dealt with later as well. So you have to convince yourself that the most important priority in your life is actually preparing for the examination and not your phone and not your calls and not your messages. Once you get it inside your head, only then, or once you understand it well, only then can you go to the second step. The second step is discipline. You have to figure out times when you need your phone and the times when you don't need your phone. For example, when you're studying in the morning, in the afternoon, or in the evening, you have to get rid of your phone. If it is within your arm's reach, you will, without any doubt, get to it and spend or waste next 2-3 hours doing something or the other on your phone. So it's very important that you understand that you need to be disciplined in order to get rid of this addiction. What you can do very easily is keep your phone outside of your reach of influence. What I do every morning is when I sit down to work or study in this table behind me, I put my phone on the other end or at the other end of the room. What that does is, if I get a call or if I get a message, I have to get up from my chair, turn around, go to the other end, pick up the phone, keep it back there itself and come back. It's too much of a hassle. So I just let it ring and I don't pick it up if I'm in the middle of something working or if my time is not over yet. So this is a very important step that you can take if you want to actually get rid of this addiction of mobile phones. Get the discipline. A lot of students answer me back when I tell them this is that, sir, I don't have a laptop or a desktop and therefore I have to study on my phone. Well, get rid of your phone and get a laptop. Get rid of your phone, get a desktop. Sell your things and get a desktop. The most important priority in your life at this point of time is preparing and cracking the examination. Therefore, it doesn't matter what you can sell. The most important gadget for you right now is your desktop, is your laptop. To give you my personal example, I have 2 laptops and 1 iPad. But if you ask me about the phone, till November 2019, I had an iPhone 5S, which was a very old school gadget. When it stopped working, then I had to get a new one. So, don't give priority, don't give any importance to your phone. It is not important in your life. You need a laptop because you're preparing for these examinations. You need continuous access to the internet in order to prepare well. The third important point is what to do when you wake up. The first thing that we normally do after we wake up is look at our phone, look at all the messages, WhatsApp, Telegram, etc., etc., and that increases the anxiety in us and breaks our concentration right away. I was also addicted to the same problem. What I did to get rid of that problem was ask myself, why actually am I looking at the phone? After I wake up, my brain tells me that I need to look at the time and know what time is it. And naturally, I would grab my phone, but then that would never end. So I got myself this cute clock, and now this is what I look at after I wake up the first thing in the morning. So you need to get rid of your phone when you're sleeping, and the first thing that you do when you wake up is, if you want to look at the time, get a clock. If you want to do something else, do anything, but don't look at the phone. The fourth important point is about dopamine hit that you get when you look at your phone. So I went through various scientific studies and I realized that it's purely biological that we are addicted to our phones. It's because whenever we hear the beep sound, we get a dopamine hit in our head. So what I did to get rid of this problem was put all my apps on silent. So whenever I'm getting a WhatsApp message or a Telegram message or anything else for that matter, my phone does not tell me anything at all. No notifications, no sounds, nothing at all. When I want to look at my phone, that is when I look at my phone. So this gives you more power and this gets you rid of the dopamine hit that you are getting when you are hearing those sounds from your phone. So the fourth thing that you need to do is put your phone on silent. The fifth and last option is for those guys who still feel that they don't have any option and they have to study with their phones only. If you don't have an option, make your phone more efficient in order to fulfill your purpose. Divide your phone into different parts. So the first screen is only for educational apps. The second screen is only for social media apps. The third screen is for something else. This way, you're making sure that you're not getting to social media apps in between your studies. The second thing that you can do is actually monitor your social media apps and control them. There are various apps online, although I've never used one and I would never use one because I focus more on keeping myself disciplined. But if you don't have an option and if you want to be more efficient with your phone, you can use all those monitoring apps. What they do is lock you out of your social media apps in different time zones. For example, I tell my app that between 9 a.m. and 12 p.m., I don't want to get access to WhatsApp and Telegram. So in that time period, no matter how hard you try, you can actually not access these two apps. Although this is a very radical step, but if you don't have an option, that it's very important that you use this step only. I'm very sure these five steps are going to make sure that you can detox yourself from the addiction of mobile phones. If you want to say something, have any feedback, have any doubts or anything at all, feel free to reach out to me by writing to me in the comment section below. All the very best. Take care.